Are you waking up early but still confused to do the things? In this video, I go deep into about the 7 powerful things you must do after wake up so that you will instantly double your productivity so that you can achieve your goals faster without wasting a single minute of your time. If you really don't know me, this is Ramesh Yadav, productivity expert. I have been in this space since more than 6 years, tried and tested multiple frameworks, habits and routines to make you more productive without procrastination at all. If you're a professional or a student or a working woman or a business owner, this video is for you. If you really stay till then, I'm going to give you my 66-day productivity challenge as a reward to you. And please grab notes. Step number one, soak in silence. You know, in most of the cases, we wake up and we quarrel with others. We over-talk. We spend most, you know, in the smartphone. That is one of the most reactive thing you should avoid at any cost. Don't start your day with reactive mode. Start in silence. Start in gratitude. Gratitude is the most powerful feeling that will heal all of your emotions, that will not only make you productive, but also make you a positive person in your life, right? Just look at the nature. Maybe you can go to your terrace and enjoy your time just looking at the nature, looking at the birds chirping, or maybe the silence, right? That soaking in silence will give you a sense of connection to your body and mind. Next time on, after you wake up, spend more time, maybe 5 to 10 minutes, no need to spend a lot of time. Maybe you can spend 5 minutes on gratitude. In the sense, maybe you will be grateful for what you have. Maybe you'll be thankful for what you really want to be. Maybe you will be proud of your family, your relationships, your accessories, whatever it is. So soak in silence is the first step you have to do after you wake up. Don't turn on the internet. Don't turn on your smartphone. Please turn off your alarm and put your phone away. Because I implemented a lot of morning routine just to test it out which habits work the best to make your day whole day productive, right? So first step is soak in the silence. Second step is feed your soul. Once you soaking in that silence, once you are enjoying that gratitude, it's time to feed your soul. We are not human beings. We are spiritual beings having human experience right now. So next time on, you should feed your spiritual being with meditation, with breathing techniques, or with journaling. Take any activity. I prefer you can take meditation, maybe 5-10 minutes. You can spend 10 minutes to 15 minutes on meditating just by focusing on the breathing techniques or pranayama, so that you will feel that you are having that spiritual human being, right? This human body is just flesh and bones. Actually, you have more power. You have really more power. Even you can spend some more time on affirmations as well. Maybe you can build your custom affirmations. In my community called Productivity Empire, we do a morning meditation challenge where I help people. It's a framework. It's a framework like meditation, visualization, gratitude, affirmations, action steps. Like that, we have a framework. If you inject that framework into your life, that will be even more productive to you. Even more soaking that soul. If you feed your soul, you get a sense of awareness. Sense of awareness in your life that gives you the next level leverage to move forward. And you can focus on writing your goal. In feeding your soul, you can focus on writing your goals. Writing has a subconscious connection with your body and mind that you are more likely to going with the in the journey of your goals. In most of the time, why we lost the track? Because we try many things. We are stuck in the shiny objects. We stuck in the negativity or tired. Maybe you feel very tired. But if you write your goals every day, maybe 1 page of your goals, don't think about how while writing the goals, just write it down, what you really want. Even if it is impossible right now, write it down. I never thought I would be a productivity expert when I started. Once I'm writing it like I'm a productivity expert, I'm a 7-figure productivity expert. Keep on repeating it every day, writing the goals. You know, most of my goals are achieved when I started writing, I think 1 year back. And now I'm writing even more big goals, like I'm reaching 1 million people and I have 1 lakh people in my community. I'm writing it down and it is happening one step at a time. So while you're writing goals, that gives you a sense of connection. When you are taking a decision to take action, right? that goals is the guiding star. That goals is the guiding star to move forward in your life. So you will focus on that. Third, do some small wins. In most of the cases, you know, if you take a tough activity after you wake up, you are more likely to procrastinate. How many times it happened? You open your email and you found some toughest customer support issue came, or maybe you wake up and you found some client is firing on you, right? The problem with that is your mind is a monkey mind. Your mind is a chain. It requires some small wins to boost. You cannot boost like this. You need that first step, first momentum step. If you have that first momentum step, it's very easy to continue that momentum to the next step. What you have to do is take a small activity. Take a small activity like making your bed or maybe brushing your teeth in a different hand. Maybe you can take a left hand, brush teeth, right? Or maybe you focus on, you can do maybe a wash your face with cold water. That would be great. Or maybe you can take a small puzzle, maybe a Sudoku puzzle or maybe some board game. So you feel like you use your mind to win that. The main intention is you have to win. If you win, then you got that sense of confidence, sense of achievement to move forward, to take the next step. That is a little bit more tougher than the first step. Got it? Fourth powerful thing you must do after you wake up is learn. Learn. You know, I think because of my birthday last week, I set a new resolution called reading one book per week. Yes, I learned from Bill Gates and how they're building these powerful empires and powerful businesses and impacting millions of people just by learning every day. And why not we? We can also learn. You know, honestly, reading books, learning is the cheapest way to become more intelligent, because a lot of people don't understand this. Maybe we are lean towards entertainment. That's okay. Entertainment is good and awesome. But learning makes you a real warrior in your life. Start learning something new. And in learning also, there is an important step. You must understand this. If you learn something which is not useful immediately, you lost that momentum. You lost the concept. You miss the entire stuff. Instead, you learn for the exact next step in your life. It may be anything. If you're a student, learn that exact next subject for your skills. If you're an employee or a professional, learn that exact next skill to scale your career. If you're a business owner, focus on that next skill which you can scale your business or which you can expand your business. Got it? Don't learn something which is important in the 10th step of your life. Learn exactly the next thing so that you're more likely to implement. The main intention of the learning is to implement. If you're not implementing, then tell me, what is the need of learning? No use, right? It's better to learn small and implement more. And we have a core rule in our community called inverse Pareto principle, which is this: spend 20% of your time on learning and spend 80% of your time on executing that learning, right? 20 minutes you can learn from this video and spend 80 minutes to implement this stuff in your life, right? Implement it, then only you will get the result. Otherwise, you will be the information junkie. Maybe after this video, go to a different video. This video to go to a different video. That will never make you productive. Honestly, it will never make you productive. It will waste your time. Maybe you feel confident, Ramesh, when I listen to you, I feel motivated. Yes, that's okay. But in order to that motivation to long last, you need to take action, even a little bit small, even if it is very small. Take small actions, okay? And you can do maybe learning from the book. You can take your own way. It may be a book, it may be a podcast, it may be a live class, it may be a recorded video, it may be a chit chat with your friend while learning, maybe discussion call. Take whatever the way you want, but diligently learn something new. Fifth powerful thing is have a strong breakfast. In most of the cases, we skip the breakfast because of some X reason, because of not prepared in the home, because of lack of time, because of this, that, other priorities. Honestly, if you miss the breakfast, actually you are in that zone of negativity, because the entire 8 hours you are not eating anything, but you wake up, maybe you have some coffee or whatever drink you have. But if you are not having that good breakfast, what happens is you are losing that energy. You feel tired. You feel not interested to work. You feel like you're in a bad mood. What's this? take some breakfast. Maybe a nutritious, essential vitamins and minerals. It may be anything. You can take an oatmeal. Maybe you can take maybe boiled eggs or maybe bananas. It's not only about maybe idli or dosa. You can take anything you want that is more nutritious to you, right? Having more vitamins and minerals that really energizes you a lot, that gives you a sense of confidence to tackle your day in a more productive way, right? Don't skip the breakfast at any cost. Even today, I finished my breakfast. Because of that, I'm very energetic. I'm recording this video early morning. Along with that, if you do the breakfast, if you finish the breakfast, it increases your energy, it increases your concentration, as well as it will make your time in a more better way, right? And one of the unfair advantage you might not get it is, in breakfast, don't look at your smartphone. Maybe you can spend a quality time with your mom, with your spouse, with your kids, so that you will help them. How is their day? And you can help them somewhere they're stuck. Maybe your kid's stuck in somewhere. You can really have a quality time in the breakfast as well, parallelly along with your energizing day. Sixth powerful thing you should do after wake up, which is give something. Yes, give something. Because, you know, I believe your life is built to give, right? Our existence, why God sent us to this earth? Because to give something to this world and make this earth a better place. I believe in it. And if you look back in the history, all the successful people, ultra successful people are the givers, not the takers, right? So if you give something without expecting anything in return, that will give you a sense of abundance mindset to enjoy the flow, to enjoy the day of the flow in a more productive and positive manner. Maybe you can help your mom in her cooking. Maybe you can help your dad in her activities. Maybe it can be 5 to 10 minutes. I'm not asking any activity. You can just do it 5 or 10 minutes. That gives you that sense of confidence to do whatever you want in the day, right? And you can do some voluntary services as well. You can do some activities, maybe 5-10 minutes of talking with strangers and helping them in their problems. So that even give a smile, that is also one way of helping. Suppose someone is in need, even you just give a smile and say hi, that gives a service, right? That gives a service to them, that makes their day more productive. Inherently, you're also becoming very productive in the journey. Seventh powerful thing you must do, which is eat that frog. You know, my favorite mentor, Brian Tracy, has written a book, Eat That Frog. In that book, he emphasized a lot about it. Eat that frog means doing that one important, uncomfortable, toughest activity in your day. Yes, do that. It seems difficult, but actually, right, once you have habituated it, suppose you take, maybe you decided to watch a video, watch a 2 hours video. Ramesh, this is the important video I should watch today and learn from that video. So you can break it down into parts, cut the frog into multiple pieces and enjoy that. Enjoy one piece at a time. Enjoy one piece at a time. And while enjoying that frog, enjoy that important activity, make sure you put your distractions away, which is very, very important. If you start something within 5-10 minutes, you jump into the, you know, you look at your smartphone, you got some vibration or notification, or someone called you, maybe someone disturbs you. You got my point? Your environment or your devices interrupts you. Make sure while doing your eat that frog, it may be an important activity, please stop the distractions until it finishes it. If you finishes it, you'll get the sense of confidence, sense of achievement to move forward in your life, to move forward in your life. And that gives you a willpower boost. It's a boost to your willpower. Yes, block your distractions and clear cut the outcome is, you know, sometimes you start randomly. Don't start randomly. You should be a clear cut. Yeah, this is what I want to finish in this. Eat that frog block. Maybe you can take your favorite. Maybe you can take your office work. You can take your business work. Usually I take this YouTube video recording as a eat my frog. Because if I shoot this video, that will give me a leverage. I can replicate this for 1,000 times or even 1 lakh times. And I know you're watching this, you're enjoying me, right? I hope you're grabbing notes as well. That's why this is the important activity in my entire business. And along with that, finish that ruthlessly without skipping it, without wasting it. And even in the work, right? Frog into parts. Frog is nothing but an important activity. Cut it into parts. And each part finish it, take a small break. In that break, don't look at your smartphone. Don't look at your people. Maybe you can take some break, look at your window, have some nature, maybe eat something, energize yourself. And until you finish it, work break, work break, work break, slots only. No more, nothing. Just do that so that you will become super productive in your life. And you might think, Ramesh, I'm waiting for that exercise. Anyone think that? Maybe you are thinking, Ramesh, when can I do the exercise? I prefer you can do the exercise on the evening times so that, you know, it's based on the person to person. If you're a person who really have that burning pain in your health, you will focus on health morning. But if you're a person who is having more desire, more burning desire to grow your business, to scale your career than your body, maybe you can give that exercise slot in the evening time. I prefer 7 to 8 p.m. is the exercise. I do weightlifting, you know, I do deadlifts, all this stuff. These seven things are very, very, very important to make your day super productive in your life. I repeat it once again. First is soak in silence, which is maybe don't quarrel, don't talk, don't use smartphone. Spend some time in inwards. Spend some time in gratitude. Two, feed your soul with some meditation or maybe writing your goals, or maybe you can focus on affirmations or breathing techniques. Step number three, do small wins. Don't go for toughest thing in the morning. You can start with the simple things like making your bed, brushing your teeth, or maybe solving a puzzle or etc. Step number four, learn exactly for the next step. Don't learn randomly, learn for the exact next step of your goal, so that you are more likely to implement it immediately in the day. Step number five, have a strong breakfast so that you avoid that laziness and then tiredness, and you have that energy to tackle the day in a more sense of a warrior. Step number six, give something. If you give something, that gives a sense of leverage, gives a sense of positive mindset to you. That is very important to scale your productivity. And step number seven, eat that frog. Maybe after the breakfast, you take that important activity and you can break it down into parts and then work, break, work, break, work, break until you finish that frog and be proud of doing it again and again so that you'll become super productive in your life. And if you really like this video, hit that like symbol and please share with one person who really needs this, because I know you're an action taker. I want your friends to be an action takers. Please share it with one person. If possible, share it in your WhatsApp groups as well, so that if one person impacted, that is what I really wanted. And if you really want to meet me live and become super productive in your life, I'm doing a live bootcamp, which is happening on the next Sunday. You can go to that link, rameshyadav.com/bootcamp, and join my bootcamp, where I'll show you how to have that productive mindset, a warrior mindset within you without negative thoughts, how to kill that procrastination and laziness without wasting your time, how to have that 100% consistency, along with how to focus like monk with a lot of trackers, templates, along with a lot of live experience for you. If you love it, just jump into my bootcamp. And this is a part of the series Best Morning Routines. If you missed that last part, maybe you can scroll to the recommendations or go to my channel and watch the first video, which is what not to do after you wake up. I have given the seven things which you must avoid after you wake up. Watch that video if you want, and type in the comment box before you leave, what is that one habit you want to build in your life, so that in the next video in this series we focus on habit building. Thank you for watching. See you next time with the one more powerful stuff. This is Ramesh Yadav, productivity expert. Bye.